Hello and welcome back to Octo Europa. And when we last left off, we hopefully took away some important lessons, that is to invest in some research more frequently. But truth be told, I'm receiving mixed messages from the game because the research has already been mentioned once without any sense of urgency. And the money is very hard to come by in this campaign, and it's very possible to screw yourself over accidentally without realizing. And I really don't want this to happen in this game, you know. But I suppose if all of our units are just the bare bones variety, we don't stand any chance, since we seem to be heavily outnumbered in every single mission, and secondary objectives are also harder to accomplish, and it's also the primary source for our income. So I suppose we have to adapt somehow, or at least try to. But for now, we see what we can do here in mission number 10 of the campaign, out of 20, I believe. And if I don't misremember, we have to take control of the canyon someplace. I think they're talking about this canyon, yes. And we have to storm at two enemy bases, one to the south and one to the east someplace. I can see a pair of bridges, which is not so nice. And this is the area that needs to be defended, I think. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 tanks available. And I think, we only have 2 cannons, the rest is all machine guns, I see. Goodie. So we cannot produce anything, and we have to rush the enemies to take over their production facilities. And also prevent the destruction of this building, I would assume. Maybe? I mean, it's going to be that situation where we have to restart the mission over and over and over again to figure out what we're supposed to be doing here. But since they said the guys to the south are weaker, then we just try to rush them, I guess. I don't think it's going to work, but we can give it a spin. And immediately we have some friends back here, of course. And taking point with machine gun tanks, right? Did upgrade some of our tanks. Granted, I do hope the upgrades are automatically applied.
Los geht's.
Okay, there's a factory.
Ja, schon unterwegs, natürlich.
There's Jawohl. A depot, great. Okay, continue south, please. There must be something else around here.
Natürlich.
They cannot be allowed to hold this position here, of course.
Natürlich. Los geht's.
Well, that's not what we need. We need the entire supply chain. Not just this thing. That's the problem. I don't see anything else. It cannot be possibly everything they have, right? Okay, there's a beach resort. There's a transporter of some type. That seems like a naval shipyard. Okay, there must be to the north then here, I think, right? Okay, goodie. And we have tons of infantry moving to our building over there, I guess.
Ein Gebäude wird gestürmt.
Yeah, right. Willy, the transporter can do this. Great. Okay, that's that thing we want to capture, of course. Willy, what? This thing again can capture this, apparently. Well, great. Okay, fantastic. Okay, whatever that is, it also needs to be captured. Not to worry about the infantry dudes, frankly. We should be able to take care of them with our machine guns, I hope. Okay, this has been captured, but it's currently useless, since we need other materials. Very slowly we're getting there. Okay, we can capture the naval shipyard too, I think, maybe. Of course, the enemies will rush us pretty shortly, so we have to start building units sooner or later. Set up our production chain. Whatever that may be.
Feindgebäude
oh, great. Okay, get going here to the naval shipyard, and I sure hope there's enough materials here, right? Wow, amazing. We can build a couple of transporters. Isn't that nice? Okay, so we set up our chain here.
Zielpunkt. Transport gestartet.
Okay, but are we not still missing one unit here or one building? I'm not quite sure, man.
Wählen Sie Zielpunkt.
Some sort of special factory. Never been introduced before, so I'm not quite sure. This building is what exactly? It's a depot. Nothing inside.
Kommandant, seit wir den Stapel aufgebaut haben, hat die UN eine Aufgabe für Sie. Zerstören Sie alle feindlichen Schiffe in 25 Minuten.
Okay, 25 minutes, whatever that means. It's already 21 minutes, so... Oh, this map is a lot larger than I had anticipated at first glance. Oh, delightful. How are we going to build some ships? Do we have to set up a different production chain for this too? Maybe we do. Okay, pause the game here and we get our bearings. Okay, it's a two-part affair somehow. Interesting. Okay, and I'm not quite sure what this thing is going to give us. I can't set any buildings when the game is paused. But one thing is for certain, we need some units here. Why to start out with to blockade this particular bridge, for instance, so... Of course, we don't have any parts for this shit, so what can we actually build for that matter? Machine gun, guys? No, it's also not possible. We're lacking in the red parts. So, do I see this correctly that we don't have a chassis factory? Yeah, I don't think we have any chassis factories, so how are we going to take care of this then? We're missing one factory someplace. They also want us to build some ships, I've heard.
Schiffswerften sind pontonartige Konstruktionen, die unterirdisch mit dem Festland verbunden sind und dort über einen weiteren Gebäude.
Oh, weiß, I have to feed this thing too, I see.
Stoffe aufnehmen kann. Über diesen werden Teile angeliefert, die für die Konstruktion schwimmender Waffensysteme benötigt werden.
Okay, we have the useless patrol boat with machine guns, then we have a useless coastal vessel with a cannon, and we have an even more useless overcraft. Good. Alright, so we need to upgrade some of them essentially, but we have to figure out our production chain first before we do anything else, because I've never done this before, of course. And I don't have a second or third factory around here. Maybe they do. I'm not quite sure yet, but for now we save the game again. Okay, another transporter maybe, because apparently it's necessary.
Der Feind naht.
Oh yeah, someone is coming, some players.
Natürlich!
Wählen Sie Zielpunkt. Transport gestartet.
Oh, yeah, there is another factory here, of course.
Schon unterwegs.
If only our weapon range wasn't so pathetic, right? And our radar range for that matter. Can we capture this, please? Thank you very much. And over here we have problems already. No, I need some infantry, I think. But we only have those. These are useless, or next to useless. Okay, so, great, and of course you just stand here, don't do anything. But goody, how many tanks is it this time around? Because at the moment I cannot produce anything but basic infantry, because this will take an eternity to capture, and it was driving through here, of course. Wow, delightful. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 already, which means we are completely screwed already, I think. Wow, delightful. Yeah, that took way too long, of course, since we need another transporter now. Actually, why? Because we have to put some parts in here, so we have to do this while game is ongoing and people are driving across our base essentially.
Transport gestartet.
Sofort.
Wählen Sie Zielpunkt. Transport.
Yeah, okay,
gestartet.
There's 10 more dudes coming and of course we have nothing available. Oh, the light form. Oh, we found a machine gun tank. One fucking machine gun tank. Oh. Already here the difficulty. Maybe we should have destroyed these bridges, but I didn't see this happening. Yeah, which one is it now? Of course, the parking right here. So they can actually do this, right? I guess. Of course, I cannot build anything. I can only build some basic infantry, and these are useless, so. Oh, maybe I can build two of them. Wow, amazing. Can we prevent the destruction of our base somehow, maybe? It could be good. Yeah, these are useless, so machine gun guys, what are they good for? Maybe it's not completely hopeless, but I don't have any optimism, frankly, for good reason. Once again, I would presume. Okay, one guy is simply not enough. So, these things are useless, especially without any upgrades. Which we can do over here, maybe. No, can make it happen back here. Yeah, destroy that bridge. That's actually to my liking. We can repair it later. Excellent. Okay, this is no longer concerning. So then we move over here and try to do the same. And we see ships everywhere, essentially. And we only have 20 bullshit minutes, which are already expiring. So, this is frankly impossible already, I see. And of course, you don't have the materials anyhow to make anything happen. Certainly not in time. Well, it's about the difficulty for the secondary objectives here in the game, of course. Well, how many ships are around? And of course, we just know where we can make this happen.
Ein Gebäude wird angegriffen. Der Feind naht.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure what they were thinking with the secondary objectives. They're frankly completely and utterly impossible sometimes, especially without advanced knowledge. Cannot make it happen.
Wählen Sie Zielpunkt.
It's completely impossible.
Wählen Sie Zielpunkt. Transport gestartet.
Yo.
How do we upgrade our ships? I don't see a research button back here. And of course, you just don't move, despite my orders here, oh goddamn. Fuck you, move over there, yes, will you? Is it even worth producing any ships, frankly? I'm not quite sure.
Ein Gebäude wird angegriffen.
What do you mean? Who is attacking? Over there? Well, maybe that's a possibility, but I don't really care. And wer wollte den fucking rebuild the bridge?
Natürlich. So as your wunsch ist. Ja.
Okay, and we're wasting our time with these fucking useless transporters here.
Zielpunkt. Transport gestartet.
Natürlich.
Wählen Sie Zielpunkt. Wählen Sie Zielpunkt. Transport.
And it's relentless spam of units over and over and over and over and over again. Oh, it works both ways, pals, I guess, right? So, they can apparently repair these bridges. I was unaware of that fact. Oh, and we have one blob of enemies over here. We have to hold off in some capacity. Of course, there are no guard orders in this game, and everyone is branded, essentially. Yes, yes, another objective.
Im Südosten dieses Gebietes befindet sich eine Insel mit gut geschützten Radaranlagen. Sie haben die Möglichkeit, 500 US-Dollar zu verdienen, wenn sie es schaffen, den Radar zu stören.
Okay, over here, they want us to destroy a radar installation, which apparently heavily defended, which means it's impossible, I see. There's no time limit, but I guess we can give it a spin. Yeah, I didn't quite think the enemies would have the combat engineer angle available, but apparently it's the case, so we pump out unit after unit, which we of course cannot make happen. Wow, that's going to take an eternity to mount any offensive whatsoever, at this pace here certainly.
Der Feind naht.
Unterwegs.
Yeah, I mean, what is this? Tell me please, what type of RTS is this?
Ja, los geht's. So ist ihr Wunsch, los geht's. Los geht's.
Okay, and of course repairing in the field is a big no-no. We have to retreat the manually one at a time. And here in this depot. Yes, we can use side advantage, but the enemies that don't come through here, period, they don't. So it's useless essentially. And how long will it take to buy a couple of basic tanks? The most basic of tanks, incidentally. Way too long. Infantry is completely useless. Ships are useless. We don't have any aircraft. So, we can barely hold onto our base here right now. Maybe that's the combat engineers we're shooting somehow with our cannons. I'm not quite sure. Could be. One of these useless boats is essentially all the supplies we have, for the most part, so... really. Well, it's hard to take the game seriously, I'm sorry. We need a couple more tanks over there, please, if you don't mind. But how long will it goddamn take, man? can I just rely on these machine gun tanks? They're useless, but despite that, we can only build one. Okay, and we need to take this out somehow, but I'm not quite sure what type of defenses they're talking about, because one is on the opposite side of the map. And I would suppose if we fail with our first or secondary objective, we can already see some ships camping back here. How successful is it going to be? I'm not quite sure.
Der Feind naht.
Or maybe we can get some of them repaired.
Ja. Ja.
Yeah, we maybe engage these ships over here. Okay, so they can actually use combat engineers, it's a miracle.
Natürlich.
So I take it back, the AI can use combat engineers.
Los geht's.
Aber du siehst a fight against the... What? Wow. Wow, it's so goddamn difficult to take the game seriously in any capacity whatsoever. What? I beg your fucking pardon? I beg your fucking pardon? They managed to build the shit again.
Sofort. Natürlich.
They have only one bridge back here, but they have to just drive across the coast and it's too far away from our base, so this will never work here, because if you're back here camping and the enemies are driving down below, they will of course be outside of weapon range, even with the quotation mark height advantage. Yeah, alrighty then, Campy, please get some fucking tanks! Please, for fuck's sake. Everything is so goddamn slow in this game.
Wählen Sie Zielpunkt. Wählen Sie Zielpunkt. Transport gestartet.
Do we even need any ships, man? This seems like a waste of resources, because we can only get so many here, I believe. Right? Okay, then we have a higher rate of production, which of course also takes some time, as you might imagine. Hopefully it's a worthwhile investment, because we cannot carry this over into our next mission. Yeah, so every single factory has been upgraded, so hopefully our little transporters don't have to wait all the time, that would be swell. Yeah, so we can speed up the process, hopefully.
Erweiterung beendet.
Yeah, there's only one port available, so it's just, oh man. This game has the perfect mixture of being super slow and also spammy at the same time. So we have to sit around here and wait and wait and wait some more. And of course we have to blockade every single bridge since they will rebuild those, apparently. Oh, and we lost the one tank against the boat, apparently. I'm not sure this even worth any investment, frankly. And who knows what level these ships are, because I would suppose the AI can also upgrade their ships, right? Otherwise it would be strange.
Natürlich. Natürlich.
Can we set aside something for research? Maybe we have only 2500 bucks, and of course, secondary objectives become almost impossible to master. So that means we have basically no cash influx. This is hard currency. We haven't even unlocked some of the other research projects because they are so pricey. And I wouldn't know until we hit one or two missions down the road and then we fail miserably because we have no money. You know, that's a problem. Yeah, okay, these tanks, which chassis are they using? Yeah, the six-wheeler, okay. But look at this, it's a minor upgrade and yet it's 2,136 bucks. And we have 2,553 bucks. Case in point, right? If I upgrade the machine gun, it's not going to give us anything whatsoever. And this is a gamble because it doesn't tell me what it does. It simply doesn't tell me anything. How can I possibly justify just spending on money? I guess then we just save scum because we have to wait for our transporters to carry these materials around. Very slowly, of course. So I guess then we just try that. I mean, they have an entire base over here, which will be super heavily defended. And I'm not sure we can even do this, because we have to, of course, move the blockade forward, back here. They have only one bridge, supposedly. Okay, yes, we got some new weapons, apparently. Isn't that lovely? But what can we do with that? I don't see them back here. Of course, all of this is manual here, getting these units repaired. And if you build some hovercraft, which you have to do, of course, for some dodge, then they can only carry 3 light tanks. And if the area is as heavily defended as it was promised, I think it's going to be impossible to tackle. And the underground exactly doesn't tell us, so it was a waste of money. Maybe this became slightly cheaper, but I don't think so, right? No, they didn't get any cheaper, so we can reload because, well, no payoff apparently. That's what I figured would happen, to be honest. So, goodie. Oh, great then. I think instead we maybe make our cannons a bit more powerful, or we upgrade the chassis. Gives us 7 energy, which is a strange way of calling it hit points. Or we can get 1 additional weapon range for our cannons. And also 5 energy for the chassis. But we can only afford 1 or the other. And this one is only a question mark, so we're just gambling, essentially. It told me it unlocked some weapons, but I didn't see any weapons being unlocked. And of course, these upgrades are also pricey. Right? Yeah, it says here. Well, I guess, what else can I say, frankly? These patrol boats are absolutely useless. And of course, what's the problem now? These are too pricey, right, by comparison. Yeah, we need more weapon parts. Back here, we need chassis parts. Oh. Yeah, this is the weapon parts factory. Of course, we're spending our money on this stuff here. We cannot afford this, because it's only for this mission. So, but we're continuously out of either of those things, I see. Maybe we should just discontinue the neighbor angle whatsoever. Beendet. Maybe we should.
Erweiterung beendet.
Yeah, that's what I meant. In these old games, it's very easy to screw yourself over accidentally, and then you play for a couple more hours, and then you discover your predicament. Which is why I'm so hesitant to spend any money whatsoever, but if we don't, all of our units are cannon fodder. And this thing managed to destroy one of our light tanks, which is already upgraded. So, okay. And there's also a red faction on the map, evidently. Either we took them out, or so I've heard. Okay, now we have 3 of those useless things. Yeah, these are all cannon boats, and now we have 3 of those. We can get them repaired, I would assume, the same as with the depot. They seem to also be benefiting from helicopter service, which is something. So if you want to take some high ground, where can we even make this happen from? Of course, the AI isn't coming at the moment, so that means they have a big blob of enemies back there, just camping, I guess. I'm not quite sure. It takes so long to get anything done in this game. It's really quite tragic. And how long will it take to build up some sort of formation? We also need some dodge and reserve to, of course, replace these. I cannot just rely on these light infantry dudes because they're absolutely useless. You can unfire whatsoever, and they can only fire point blank, of course. But we also upgraded this once, I see. We also have limited storage for ammunition and gasoline, of course, or diesel, whatever we're using. These don't seem to be very fuel efficient at all. These ones we have to upgrade later. Maybe there is a naval research facility somewhere. Who knows? I'm not quite sure I'm reading these numbers correctly, to be frank, but we can maybe base our decisions around that, while we still have to wait for our transporters to move around. I think having this many also leads to traffic jams, but what else can we do? We can give them, I think, 4 orders in total per vehicle, but it makes them less efficient. Yes, okay, they're only sending out pioneers at the moment, or so we see. Oh, hopefully we can at least destroy these couple of vehicles here, even though it doesn't pay us any money. No, we cannot. We cannot make it happen. We are branded. Alter, die branded. Okay, good to know. Thanks for the confirmation. Okay, maybe it would have been possible to destroy these with advanced knowledge, but it's not going to be the only naval force on the map, of course. And how long will it take to blow apart a single tiny ship? There we go, one guy destroyed. Yes, I could set my tanks in here, but I don't want to risk them. They need to stop the pioneer over there. Okay, good. Wait. These things apparently are battleships by comparison to our trash. Isn't that good? So how do we get them repaired? Apparently we don't. Maybe it's by air. So we have lost all of our heavy ships, essentially. Ha ha heavy. In quotation marks, of course. I guess that we're going to risk some careful scouting with the remainder of our little flotilla back there. Okay, can we get a discount on the production maybe once in a while? That would be swell. So 15, 20. And this calls for a naval invasion, or what are they telling us here? As we find out. But it's going to be a long grind first again, I can already tell as much. Maybe we can take control of the high ground in the middle someplace and reduce the pressure on our base. I don't think it's going to be that easy. Okay, that's the radar installation. I see... looks like rocket artillery by chance. At least already 10 units. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and of course we come under fire. So they want us to mount a naval invasion of this island, and we cannot order any shore bombardment, and if we land our units here, 3 units at a time, very slowly. Manually, of course, 1 landing craft at a time. Okay, and of course, they only have tanks over here, not a single machine gun.
Der Feind naht.
Hisst die Segel.
Ein Gebäude wird gestürmt.
What do you mean? How?
Ein Gebäude wird angegriffen.
What? How?
Ein Gebäude wird angegriffen.
How? How? How did they manage to get past there? How? How is that remotely possible? How is that remotely possible? And of course the game doesn't tell me which transporters were destroyed, so I have to figure the shit out again manually. How in the fuck? How is that possible? Hä? man, we lost a couple of transporters and I have no idea which ones they were. Not the slightest idea. These things have a party completely crapped out.
Wählen Sie Zielpunkt.
Aber eben bothering with ships in this mission. I'm not quite sure who's still on route, by the way. There's an overview from what I can see. Did they just come from off-screen somehow and somewhere? I have no idea, frankly. This game leaves so many questions unanswered. So I have to assume
Wählen
something,
Sie
I guess.
Zielpunkt. Wählen Sie Zielpunkt. Transport gestartet.
And this game is so puzzling sometimes already then. So we found in punishable photos over there essentially. But can we see anything else with our ships here maybe? There's that one bridge, of course. Maybe that was indeed all the naval forces then in the area, but there's no way we can build up a small flotilla to take care of these cannon boats back there. That would have been impossible within the given time frame. So if you mount a naval invasion, I'd rather not, but if you want to, what are the opportunities? Also, I would suppose the factory is right back here. Okay, so aside from the radar installation and the rocket artillery and these 20 or so tanks, we didn't see anyone on our journey. Well, it's booked soon. There are some green dudes just waiting there. But of course, seeing them doesn't mean we can shoot them. Okay, a couple more tanks. So that makes... okay, the base is over here. There is one factory of theirs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, that's all we can see right now. But of course, there will be way more. But buildings, once we see them, they will be permanently marked on our map, thankfully. And they only want to give us 500 bucks for this objective. Oh, it needs to be naval invasion. There's nothing else possible, so we have to rely on hovercraft, which we have to build at great expense. Slowly, for that matter. Okay, so, goodie, all three bridges are destroyed. Yeah, what's the source of the traffic jam? No idea. Okay, we added to the lengthy list of bugs in this game. Okay, this factory seems to be undefended, but of course you cannot see very far. So that makes, I think this is a parts factory. I'm not quite sure though. I see number one, number two marked on the door. So that means they probably have more assets over there somehow. But we have to repair at least the one bridge to cross it. Which one is the most usable one? I'm not quite sure. Okay, we saw more ships over there. Okay, so that's what I figured. Remember how short the time frame was? We have to capture the facility, set up the entire production chain, and we have to destroy every single ship on the entirety of the map within 20 minutes. Which of course is impossible.
Kanonen bereit.
Ja, that's of course impossible. Cannot be done. I'm not quite sure what they're thinking with these objectives, frankly. Ja, this guy, for instance, doesn't even feel like getting in weapon range. So, oh, they could theoretically interfere with our potential naval invasion, so we probably should destroy them. But yeah, of course, there's another trio of enemies over there. Patrumpo eben. Yeah, okay, we don't have the firepower for this, incidentally. Yeah, there we go. These are superior to our vessels, and we cannot build or upgrade anything else right now. Okay, so that's what I figured. It's once again a completely impossible secondary objective, even with advanced knowledge, it cannot be done. So once again, I have to ask what the game developers had in mind when they designed these mission objectives. I mean, evidently not our interests, but otherwise. It's going to be an absolute grindfest already, I can tell as much. And never mind all the ships, which of course we had no chance of ever destroying in any capacity. There's no way you can make this happen. I mean, how though? We rush the enemies as soon as possible. And we captured the ship, yeah. Then we have to capture the other manufacturing parts. Also get everything set up, wait for our items to be moved over there. And then also produce these units and then take care of everything on the entirety of the map within 20 in-game minutes. I mean, how? If it only was this pair, then maybe, but over here we have like 6 more ships waiting for us. Never mind the naval invasion opportunity on this island. And we saw like 20 tanks and rocket artillery against which we cannot retaliate. So, is it even worth spending the effort and time most importantly? Because it only gives us 500 bucks, which granted is a lot in this game, but still. It may not be worth the headache, to be honest, because of the naval invasion angle primarily. We have to get all of our hovercraft over here, then we have to unload one after another with 3 units maximum. There's no optimization whatsoever, we already saw this. So, and these are also incidentally the most expensive unit. And they're also useless and they cannot fire, of course. Well, we don't need any escorts, but you know what I mean. And despite all this waiting around, we can still only afford a couple of them at most right now. So, oh, goodie. I think I'd rather go with the land invasion, potentially. And see how well it goes. We can still just leave one building intact and destroy the rest over there, maybe. Und try to, if you feel like it. Okay, then. Well, I suppose only the cannon makes any sense. The rest is next to useless, so... And there's a big traffic jam because there's only one depot and hence only one loading port. Right? And of course, the transporters waiting, they also interfere with our pathfinding at the other side of the production line back here. I mean, I have no idea how many units are waiting over there. Must be at least 30 or so. Yeah, I don't think that's working all that well here. But we're still figuring out the production chain in this game. All supposed to be efficient and optimal. I don't think that's the way to do it. So I gave everyone the movement order and 5 seconds later they start to move and then they get into another traffic jam. Are these actually upgraded tanks? I should hope so. But it should be. The upgraded chassis twice and the cannon 3 times in total. There are no ready points in this game, of course, in case you're wondering. You have to do this manually. Of course, these units will be blasted in instance if we have to have some reinforcements on hand. So chassis parts are the bottleneck, I see, right, aren't they? Of course, they destroyed one of our transporters, and of course, I don't know which one it was. We're still waiting to get out of here, as a matter of fact. And we also need an engineer, of course, to rebuild that bridge, because the enemies have stopped doing this, so maybe not. Okay, they're only interested in the shortest route, for whatever reason. Could be.
Sofort.
Okay, what are you doing, though?
Zielpunkt.
Okay, weapons factory into the harbor, apparently. Is it even necessary still? If we want to mount an invasion, then we have to save up at least a couple of materials in the meantime. So this is going to be enough. We need to double the number of units, which will interfere with our pathfinding, of course. Well, this game is certainly a very slow burner. So I will probably have to sit around and grind up some units here off screen just to get anything going. Yeah, probably exactly what I have to do. Of course, we don't know about high ground or trees or anything in the way, so we have to assume something. Probably the wrong assumptions, but we have to do something, of course. Okay, I can see some chassis parts are finally coming in here, which is good. And... sure, that seems sensible, der Game.
Ja, schon unterwegs. Los geht's.
What? I said it's much better, we'll just be camping back there. And they have like 50 units camping because they have non-stop production essentially. Wow, isn't that delightful? So all of our units we sent over here have been decimated. Okay, well then we have to wait for them to come over here and take the high ground. And we send some combat engineers over there, maybe. That's not going to work with this canyon here. So, man, this game is just... oh, boy. Naval invasion, 3 units per hovercraft, all manually done. We could repair this bridge, I suppose, and send some units that way. Maybe. Oh, since we have to rebuild everything from scratch anyhow, then I guess we do exactly that. Also, we have to make some room for the combat engineer, don't we? If we use him. Okay, so must be like 50 tanks or so. There mit dem Boom. I saw some machine gun tanks, but that doesn't matter. So, what is it this time around? It's the chassis parts again, right? Yeah, that's not going to be enough. We need more units on this angle, of course. So maybe we swing around. If only hadn't sent these people over there, but without any reconnaissance, which is barely possible. I didn't know, of course. Alright, we need to mount a two-pronged attack, but as soon as we build one bridge, they will stream over here continuously. I guess we can rebuild this and then hope that the enemy is stupid enough to send only a couple of guys at a time and we engage them on this ridge line, maybe. But even that I struggle to see as a realistic proposition. But if they point out the cannon specifically, maybe we use this height advantage, quotation mark, to our advantage here, indeed. And of course, if we are slightly too far away, we don't fire like ever. This certainly won't be enough. This is a hopeless situation over here. These guys have the longest range weapons we possess at the moment. It's not a guarantee they will fire, of course, but then again. I think these are already too far away. I don't think we can intercept anyone back there. So as the last opportunity type of affair, we block them in case, you know. So we have to cheese the eye, I guess, and hope they don't have the numbers to break for our alliance, which they probably do regardless. But we wait for some materials to be delivered in the meantime. And back here we are stockpiled enough for a whopping three or so boats. Cody, I think we saved the dodge for the hovercraft, if anything. So we need at least two combat engineers. I'm not quite sure if they can engage our combat engineers from back there. Let's find out. These do take special materials.
Ja. Natürlich. Auf Ihr Wort.
And of course they also move very slowly indeed.
Sicher sofort.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, they couldn't move any slower, of course. And I've also noticed they suffer from the same pathfinding issues, like here, as with any other vehicle in this game. Yeah, that's what I figured, they just don't fire, it's too far away, so we can't have that.
Der Feind naht.
Okay, the Feind managed to rebuild this. Can we maybe open fire on the enemies? Are these people even firing? I don't think they are firing, right? I'm not so certain about this, but maybe we can cheese this down here. Just have to make sure we get a weapon range and stay there. But it still is not sufficient a number of units to make any push right now, I would figure. Light infantry dies in 2 seconds, they only build tanks on infantry. Who is actually firing right now? It's hard to see, yeah? Maybe they are firing, but it's hard to tell. Okay, if they expand their forces like this, then maybe we can work with that. Maybe, it's a big maybe though. But of course, they had more units than just these over there. Of course, you cannot fight on the bridge, it's too dangerous. I suppose if it comes down to it, we produce a couple of these here, because they are much cheaper. We upgraded them ever so slightly, but still, hardly that outstanding by all considerations. Yeah, this is not going to be enough for a push, we can only mount the defense and then use their opportunity of weakness maybe to strike. But even that I struggle to see as a realistic proposition once again. And I guess you keep yourself in reserve in case you need to rebuild the bridge. Took you long enough to move your aspect there anyhow. So naval invasions of course are no show in Los Angeles. So well, they do have like 50 units over there, bare minimum I would assume. And they're building more as we speak. Reminds me already of some missions in Star Trek New Worlds incidentally. But even then it was not as headache inducing to figure out the strategy. And the enemies, they did have some weaknesses sometimes. But here it seems to be a different story actually. Fortunately so. Of course, the too many units means we have more traffic jams, so ideally we want to avoid this. I'm not quite sure how quickly they will react to us rebuilding the bridge. No idea. Okay, hotkey number 2 for you, and the other guys will be hotkey number 1, whatever remains of them. And that we see what we can do. Of course, we have to cross the bridge first, and then we can fire. If we're on the bridge, then we get isolated as before, everyone will perish.
Yeah.
Everyone will perish indeed. Okay, build the bridge, please. I would suppose there are already people waiting, right? Okay, there's some sort of civilian building. Okay, 2 tanks have made it across. And then we have the enemies coming over here, of course. Can we maybe take some high points? I don't think we can. Okay, now keep moving, please. Did they actually manage to drive through here? They may have. Oh, you cannot be serious with this. Oh, there we go. So no, don't do this, please. Don't do this. Retreat, retreat, retreat. Turn around. And then we lost all of our vehicles on the bridge, of course. Oh, the light four. So it's a disaster already, I see. Oh, oh, hello there. Hello there, friends. And where are we going? I have no idea. And they rebuilt the bridge again from this angle. Okay, goody, goody, goody. Can build 3. We lost 30 or so, I think. They still keep coming, of course. Where are you going? I have no idea. Because, ah, this is not possible from this side, I would figure. Can we please move our asses over there finally? What the fuck are you doing? Get off the way. No! Get over here. Get fucking over here. Yeah, I've produced so many units, there's actually a traffic jam back there. I cannot select just combat units, doesn't work. What? They're producing non-stop essentially, and the reason for them not attacking us was the fact that they couldn't path to our bridges essentially. That was the only limitation for them. How in the world are we going to do this? What? You know what, in the early missions, these were somewhat clunky but manageable, but I think this campaign has really turned to the crapper. There's no other way to put it, there's no resemblance of balance whatsoever in this game any longer. Alright friends, I finally caved in and just needed myself some money as well as materials, because it was a very slow going, needless to say. And some of the material research projects take up to 10 minutes each or something like this. I'm not joking here, and they're also ridiculously pricey. Because if you look at chassis number 5, now it's 26,000 and it was the same theme for some of the other ones. And as a reminder, our secondary objectives, they pay out maybe 2,000 tops and we get maybe 2,000 at the end of the mission. I know some of them are more valuable, but even with advanced knowledge, I struggle to see how we can do them. As we've seen in this mission with the naval assets and last mission when it came to taking out the entirety of the map all at once within maybe 2 or 3 minutes at tops, you know, something like this. So I don't think that's going to be happening. And indeed, with these research projects, we are only throwing the dice, of course. And as a reminder, we have to upgrade every single weapon and everything else separately, including the chassis, so we can either specialize or we don't do anything at all. And of course, this is still unproven since the enemies simply cannot path to us right now, due to their overwhelming numbers, apparently. Okay. Yeah, we are just throwing the dice over here, essentially. But even had I known this from the very start of the campaign, I really struggle to think as to how we can keep up research-wise, because money is so tight, and secondary objectives are very hard to achieve, especially at this point. I mean, upgrading the machine guns doesn't do anything, and upgrading the cannon for our ground vehicles doesn't do the same for our naval vessels, by the way, so there should be a naval research facility someplace, I think. Maybe? I mean, where else can we do this? It's not here, it's not there, so... Beats me, frankly, but our ships without upgrades aren't very useful, of course. I guess then we upgrade the cannons again, I suppose. Maybe. I mean, this will take like a good 5 minutes, I believe. Okay, so we can't upgrade anything back here. And neither can we upgrade anything from back here. And as you can tell, it's still cannon zero. Even though it's the same cannon, presumably. Okay, reconnaissance has told us there aren't many things going on back here, presumably. And the island, of course, is heavily defended. And since we cannot mount any invasion without unloading our vessels. So we have to send in the combat engineer first to build us a dock of some type. And then we can unload 3 units at a time, very slowly and separately, of course. So this will be a bit difficult. But maybe it will be enough of a distraction to allow us to well, confuse them over here somehow. I don't think we can, but I guess we give it a spin. I mean, we do have some units parked for this precise reason, don't we? Okay, squad number 2. Except for you. And over here we do the same with squad number 1. It's the weaker formation, but then again, what can we do? Yeah. And you can certainly come a little bit closer. And of course, mounting a naval invasion over here is difficult to orchestrate and also will be a suicidal affair. So we have to hope for the best. No, we don't try to board the ship, thank you very much. Yeah, you have to deselect the units before you click on the ship, it's very important. It's not very intuitive, but it's essential in this game. So try to get as close as possible. And then we try to unload our tanks back here. At least all the vehicles are upgraded automatically across the entirety of the map. So there's that. And as a reminder, there are only 3 light tanks each in here. 3 light tanks mates. So, okay, good idea. And we can only unload infantry without a loading dock. We could destroy the power station, I guess. But it only slows down the research and also doesn't matter because they have, wow, 50 units camping back here, another 50 units camping over there. But I think we've earned ourselves a firebox display, wouldn't you think? Of course, I need to get out of the way then, after all. Okay, then, I'm not sure how quickly they will react, but if they do, we will see them. There's only one way to find out, right? Yeah, we are Alshita, evidently, because we have to for the first time. It's a shame, but what can we do? You saw that it's impossible. Even if it wasn't, it would take an absolute grind fest to get through there. And I don't want to subject myself to that. I'm playing the games for fun, not work, you know. So, what is that, guess? If the game doesn't play fair, why should we here? Yeah, we go finally wake up.
Der Feind naht.
Ah, ich werde dir, what I figure would happen. Can we build this here quickly? Please, quickly asset. Okay, you're now in the way, I would figure.
Jawohl, wird gemacht.
Oh, then we do some scouting, because these people are not good for much else. Maybe we can intercept some guys over here with the cannons, I hope at least. Okay, is there anything else going on though? Let's just find out. Are they coming? Surprisingly, they aren't coming. So we can unload some vehicles over there, maybe. As a third strike force. Eventually, we get this done. Thank you very much. As a matter of fact, come over here. So we can load a couple more units once it's necessary, which it will be, of course. And of course, as a reminder, we have to do all of this manually. This will, of course, also impact my own energy production. And the moment we don't know what an emergency generator is, so we cannot. Okay, finally. Yeah, by the way, emergency generators are mentioned in the manual, but we cannot build them right now. So what is it, I guess? So, okay, then we build a couple more of those tanks we unlocked, whatever that does for us. They seem to have more hit points, though. Oh, not quite, because we upgraded, of course, the other one. But regardless, we need to build a couple of them, I'm sure. Yeah, we have to wait for this thing somehow, even though there's no risk of collision. Beats me, frankly. And then we wait for our transporters to get over here, which will take an eternity, of course. Okay. Hopefully we don't have to do this too often in this mission, I should say. I'm not quite sure if the enemy keeps pace with their own upgrades, so if they just matched one for one, which would make this impossible, frankly, but then again, we don't know. I think the idea was to camp along both sides of the canyon, I think it was the idea, but of course it doesn't work out since the eye didn't fall for our trap. Either that or they cannot path to us because there are too many units back there. Either of those things. Yeah, speaking of things being a little bit difficult right now to manage. Oh, then we find a different parking spot for them over here somewhere. Oh, wow, first Freda has made it back there. Amazing. Wow, and we get 500 bucks for our trouble. 500 golden bucks that pays for an upgrade for light machine guns. Only for level 2 or 3 maybe. If it is the case, I'm not quite sure how we're supposed to finance these things. We are the halfway point of the campaign and they simply don't give us any money and some of the secondary objectives are frankly impossible. And I don't see any other money just laying around on the map, or do you? Granted, some of the secondary objectives are secret until we discover them. I don't think we can shoot this building, it's way too far away for this. We would need some naval artillery on our own. I guess then we ignore the angle over here because there's literally nothing else they can do. Yeah, we cannot drive through here, otherwise I would have done this to shoot people on the bridge, but that's not doable, I'm sorry. Let's just save the game again as a dirty cheater. And then we move over here and see what we can do. So, you will cross the bridge, you make yourself a nuisance, and then we see how the enemies will be reacting over there. Will be pretty important, I think. But first things first, cross that bridge, please. I think they will break up with this here probably, but we shall see that, since our ships are in range. But first things first, to get all these vehicles, yes, across the bridge, please. Yeah. You start capturing some buildings, please. Yeah. Well, eventually we get it done, I guess. But once we shoot the transports, they should wake up, but maybe they just kind of path to us, could also be. Yeah, who is shooting? I don't see anybody. Oh, there's one tank. Oh, who cares ultimately? Oh, they still aren't waking up, I see. Oh, then we can consolidate our position over here somehow. Okay, of course you stopped capturing this, unfortunately, because there was a transporter in the way. Alright, okay, then they're still not waking up. So there's the depot, which we also need to capture. No, it's not even the depot. There's even more factories back here. And how many transporters and helicopters do they have all over the place? Sorry there. Okay, so this... I think the factory must be over here, the depot, whatever it was. Oh, probably. Can we obey my orders? Capture these buildings, you idiot. Okay, they're not giving chase, surprisingly. Okay, it's still a complete and utter grind first, that's what I figured would happen. Yeah, they have so many units, they simply cannot move because there's no room to move, courtesy of pathfinding issues. You simply cannot make up shit like this, right? So, what are we doing next? I'm not quite sure. As soon as we rebuild the bridge, then we of course come over here. These are useless without any transporters, so we have to capture the depot.
Sofort.
Feindgebäude übernommen.
Oh, delightful. Yeah, there must be right here the depot. There's so many units, they simply cannot move. I'm not quite sure how much QA testing went into this game. Some of the missions in the recent past here, they have been terribly designed, frankly, if I'm honest. I don't think it's the intended way of things to play out, but I don't see the alternative video.
Feindgebäude übernommen. So, was
Ihr Wunsch ist? Ja, okay, das war gut happen. There must have at least 50 units over there. Okay, that's not the else we can do at the moment, so let's just save the game again, build these bridges and hope for the best, right? Yeah, these are my orders, rebuild the bridge. We have another wake up, so we have to get moving.
Wir liegen unter Feuer.
Ihr Befehl.
The icons also look way too similar.
Wir liegen unter Feuer.
Ah, our boat's actually shooting something, that's a miracle.
Wir liegen unter Feuer.
Yeah, it's a bit of attrition regardless of how we look at it, right? There's the depot and it's still producing non-stop without delay.
Wir liegen unter Feuer.
Are you still capturing this? No, we stop capturing, of course. Yeah, well, traffic jams, and more traffic jams. I don't care about what it takes, man. That's the degree of level design in this game. The apex of level design. Did we finally capture this? Yes, I think we have. Excellent. All cheat codes would have been like a 6-hour ordeal, I think. Probably. So finally we've taken control of the enemy somehow. A miracle. Yeah, and this should be the end of the mission, I hope, right? And there are how many transport helicopters around here for fuel and ammunition? Quite a few, evidently. Okay, good here. Oh, excellent. Alright. But I guess there's nothing else to do, so we just speed up the process because there was a lot of waiting in this mission here, surely. Mm-hmm, so we destroyed 206 units. Fantastic, and apparently there was a second mission, which of course we couldn't do. Since there was no time allotted to this, courtesy of the Naval Action back here. And they give us 1,200 bucks, and you saw the prices there for these research projects, yes? Good, good.
Atlantic Basis 96, Anflug 671. Landeerlaubnis erteilt in Landebucht 5.
Willkommen in Europa. Hier regnet es immer.
Wirklich? Da müssen traurige Leute hier sein.
Ja, die Leute auf dem Kontinent weinen den ganzen Tag.
Yes, welcome to Europe. Based in the Atlantic. Or specifically?
Endlich. Ich kann es kaum erwarten, in trockene Sachen zu kommen.
Sind Sie die drei Soldaten von West Point? Gut, dann folgen Sie mir bitte.
Hey. Was für ein Service, man wartet schon auf uns.
Das ist mir fast schon zu aufmerksam.
Auf wichtige Leute passt man am besten auf. Sieht es von der Seite.
Oh, maybe there's a special mission in store for us for our free friends.
Europa ist nun Teil des internationalen Berkowitz Corporation Handelsnetzwerkes. Zwar versteht niemand, warum ein amerikanischer Konzern mit Kontakten bis in die höchsten UN-Kreise nun mit dem Feind handelt, aber vielleicht sollten wir Militärs uns nicht in die Politik einmischen. Nutzen wir unsere eigenen Möglichkeiten, die Preise für den Feind hochzutreiben. Seien Sie der Erste, der das neue Handelszentrum findet und machen Sie ein paar Geschäfte.
Okay, apparently our supplier is indeed supplying both sides of the war. This corporation mentioned in the top, the unpronounceable one. And apparently we need to capture a, was it again, commerce building of some type, which apparently is a new item I've never seen before. And we also got some items to play with. Alright, finally we have a tracked vehicle, which of course we have to upgrade separately. All delightful, and of course we have to buy some units from them. Okay, interesting. So we have to invest our own dodge for this presumably. Okay, but hopefully it won't be as hectic as the last mission, or next to impossible for that matter. But I think it's all we can do for today, so as usual, I thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.